information and be able to actually compare the differences between their life and what they see other people experiencing. Now, how does this apply to reform? Well, essentially, we can look at the human nature. People inherently will gravitate towards a better life as well as the freedom of choice. What we can see today is that when somebody sees that they can have better living conditions, they will then strive to achieve them. So what we can see is that the internet provides a certain amount of global awareness and actually will give incentive for people to revolt. So the reason that citizens stay passive in these autocratic states is because they don't realize that they can have better. And what we believe is that the internet actually grants these people a basis to fight from, and it gives them a reason to actually go out and strike out against their government. Now, without the knowledge that the internet brings about the outside world, these people are unable to actually have motivation to work for this better life. So we believe on side proposition that once people know that they can do better, they will fight to achieve it. Now we can take an example and look at the Arab Spring from this. Due to Facebook and online awareness and the penetration of the internet into certain countries, such as Egypt and Libya, we can see that these people were educated about the things that they were being denied. They saw the rights that they were being denied by their government and therefore managed to take hold and strike out against the government to achieve their life. So what we can see in summary of this pillar of human nature is that autocratic states still exist because these people are uneducated. What the internet changes is that it brings this free flow of liberal ideals to educate these people. And finally, in relation to reform, we can see that because people naturally gravitate towards a better life, this will then cause them to actually act out against their governments and destroy the existence of the autocratic states. So now let me move into my second pillar, which has to do with indirect unification. So now this, again, I'm going to be asking and answering two major questions. Now the first of which is, why is the internet different from any form of communication that we had before? And second, how does this new form of communication change social structures within autocratic states? So first of all, why is the internet different? Now what the internet manages to do is it allows citizens to collaborate anonymously regardless of locational restrictions. And it's a mechanism of communication that is better than anything that we've seen. Now this is because the internet is faster, it is more direct, it is more effective, and it is more organized. So what this means is that people who could not previously gather in certain locations due to the restriction of government, such as with police, can now meet on the internet anonymously. And the government can do little to actually try to stop them, except with censorship. And the thing with censorship is that there are always people looking to break into the outside world. And there will either be people from the outside world that manage to break into the communication of these autocratic states, or there will be people in these states that manage to reach the outside world. Now, because of this form of communication, what we can see is that the physical presence of the government is actually eliminated, or rather decreased. And what we can see is that the internet manages to override the sort of power that the government currently holds. Because these governments can prevent these people from physically meeting and therefore gathering support, but they can't stop them on the web. So what we can see is that this removes a sort of physical threat that used to hang over the citizens. Would you not agree?
No, madam. How exactly would you get the internet to these nations that do not have it? That's the reason they're in reform, because they cannot get the internet in there. So there's no pragmatism to your argument.
If you decided to pay attention to the definitions that we laid out in this debate, we did define the age of the internet as countries which have access to the World Wide Web. Under this definition, if a country is not living in the age of the internet, then autocracy is not, according to the resolution, dead in it. So let me move back to my argument. So we can see, let me move into my second question under my argument, which is what exactly does this internet and new form of communication change? What we see is that this allows large movements to actually form apart from the government and allows certain messages to reach a large audience beyond simply personal contact and private meetings. Now again, let's take a look at the case study of the Arab Spring. Now we see that protests in Libya were actually specifically organized on Facebook. And moreover, what happened was that these protests were then documented photographically and on video and then uploaded so that there was global awareness about what was actually going on there. And what this also meant is that the people in local areas could then join in on this protest because they had the knowledge and were aware of what was now going on in their area. Now, prior to the invention of the internet and this free flow of ideas, these citizens would not have been previously able to actually gather and have these protests. So what we see is that with the internet, the government loses power and therefore has to become more concerned with citizen unrest. This means that they are now responsible for the citizens and have to look out for the rights of the citizens, and therefore defeats the autocratic state of the single party or single person state. And so what we see is that what the internet does is that it forces these governments to actually reform for the benefit of the citizen. And this is because of the ability of the citizen and the empowerment So now, what exactly have I talked about today? As the first speaker of side proposition, I defined the terms, I presented our case line, and I talked about our first two contentions of the day. The first of which had to do with human nature, in which I told you why autocratic states exist due to the lack of education and awareness within citizens. What the internet changes about this, which is that it brings a spread of liberal ideals and manages to give these citizens a reason to actually act against the government, and finally how this applies to reform, which had to do